Hi, let's talk about the arteries of the posterior mediastinum. So our story's protagonist is going to be the thoracic aorta, which has three parts: the ascending aorta, the arch of aorta, and the thoracic part of the descending aorta. That thoracic part of the descending aorta, more often than not, is referred to as the thoracic aorta, which can sometimes be a little confusing. It's going to host both parietal and visceral branches. Its parietal branches are going to serve the thoracic wall, so those are going to be posterior intercostal arteries. We'll have one at every vertebral level. And there will also be superior phrenic arteries supplying the diaphragm with blood. The visceral branches are going to include a variety of targets. So there will be bronchial arteries supplying the bronchi and parenchyma of the lung. There will be pericardial arteries supplying the pericardium with blood. And there will also be esophageal arteries supplying the esophagus with blood. Now here's a view of the thoracic aorta reflected away from the body wall. So there's the ascending aorta, there's the arch of the aorta, and here is that thoracic part of the aorta. And we can see a collection of arteries here that are all going toward the posterior body wall. So these are going to be posterior intercostal arteries. Just inferior from this, we can see two of our bronchial arteries. These are in all likelihood left bronchial arteries. The right bronchial artery I don't see. More often than not, it's generally a branch of that third right posterior intercostal artery or the superior left bronchial artery. The pericardial arteries tend to be quite small and difficult to see. Since the pericardium has been removed here, very frequently those can be torn. But we can see a couple of esophageal arteries through the esophageal plexus there. These tend to be somewhat irregularly dispersed throughout the length of the esophagus there. And one last trait, although it's not on our list here, it is on our list of structures. Erase this here. We can see the thoracic duct ascending here in the posterior mediastinum as it transitions into the superior mediastinum. So these are the major arteries and branches of the posterior mediastinum. Thank you very much for your time.